candidates for the 16th. Maybe first, gentlemen, second, but same question. If you look at the map, most of the county, most of the district is not the city of Reading, where I live. I feel, because I have just moved into Reading 2 years ago from District 6, that there is a lot of prejudice towards the city as a city, toward the residents, toward the school district. Okay, so now each of you pretend you got this, you got the job, you represent us all, and we're a teeny little tiny part of this huge geographic area. How do you help us feel loved and welcomed?
That's a great question. I think it's so important to recognize, first, the power that Reading has right now, actually, in getting us elected, right? So let's recognize the power that this city has. In fact, in the last election, we had incredible turnout from Reading, so one of the highest turnouts ever in Reading City. We delivered so many votes here, and this is really, for us, you know, a part of our winning strategy, of course, is to turn out Lancaster, Reading, and Coatesville. So I just want to emphasize that Reading actually has a lot of power if it chooses to use that power. And we will work very hard again to turn out Reading in a slightly higher percentage than what we did last time. By encouraging folks to participate in the process, and we've got a number of ways that we're going to do that this time. But to answer your question more fully, we will be doing town halls up here. We will be making sure that folks are engaged, not just around election time, but all the time. So finding ways, the most important thing about communicating with folks today is meeting them where they're at. Is one of our biggest challenges as candidates. Why? It's a challenge for everybody, but for nonprofits or whatever. So you have folks on the older end of the spectrum who might not be on technology at all. You have younger folks who are. What we know from, for example, Hispanic folks tend not to be on Facebook, right? But disproportionately, they are not. So things like that. So meeting folks where they are and going to their communities, meeting with them there, and making sure we're really providing the listening piece that I think people are craving, that we hear them, and then we put those things into action. And I do think, particularly around education, healthcare, and jobs, I think, that, again, those are the things that folks want. But if that's not correct, we want to hear them and hear what's different. So just starting that conversation so that they understand, because I think the listening piece is so critical. When people feel heard, and also when they can see results in their own communities, that's when they start to feel like government's working for them, and that's what I'll do.
Yeah, obviously, I agree with a lot of things that Christina said, that Reading does have a lot of power, way more power than it recognizes. And that is even true when I was superintendent. School board said to me, how are you ever going to find a good superintendent to come to the Port Reading? Well, you have one of the best superintendents in the state right now. You're the fourth largest school district in the state of Pennsylvania. So if you just maximize it to the adults, you have a very large population here, a strong Latino population. However, they feel disenfranchised. They feel disenfranchised for many reasons. And I think we have to find ways to reach out to that community and gather support. One of the first things we'll do also is, if you're elected, you have to have a district office. I work for a district office in Reading. Reading has been important today. I spent 7 years of my career up here. I invested a lot in the school district and Reading in this community, and I'm seeing a turnaround. I look at people like Craig Pohl, who had the courage to put a hotel in the middle of Reading, and everyone told him not to do it. Okay, when I became superintendent, I can't tell you how many people told me, do not do it, it would ruin your career. I was told it over and over. Okay, but yet, we had the courage to do that. And Craig Pohl has the courage to put a hotel right in the city. And the city of Reading is coming back. There's a lot of good things happening here, and I think we need to continue to maximize that. And you have a voice. And unlike the previous congressman, Joe Pitts, who I then said over and over, he'd established in Reading, and you actually see put a district office right here in Reading, okay, because I believe in the city, and I believe the city is on upswing and moving into that journey, and I would represent you